One of the recent recommendations of the panel investigating the Sandy Hook school massacre was for greater government oversight of homeschooling, even though the killer Adam Lanza spent most of his youth in public school and was only homeschooled briefly at age 16. Critics say Lanza's problem was severe mental illness, not home education. But the announcement by the Sandy Hook panel set off alarm bells and reinforced a suspicion by homeschool advocates that state officials will look for almost any excuse to regulate home education. Only a handful of nations in the world allow homeschooling without some sort of restriction. The impulse to clamp down on homeschooling is, according to Mike Donnelly of the Homeschool Legal Defense Association, a transnational mindset among bureaucrats.
When you look around the world, you can see there is a common mindset in a lot of government bureaucracies which wants to control what children learn and how they learn. They want to put them in state schools where they can control the curriculum. They want to have more control over parents.
In Ireland, a homeschooling mother of six was recently jailed for failing to pay a homeschooling fine. The laws in Sweden are so tough, the leader of Sweden's homeschool movement had to escape to Finland. But Germany is most notorious for what some call its persecution of homeschoolers. Germany continues to be a very hostile environment for parents who want to homeschool their children. And the German government seems to have shrugged off worldwide criticism that it violates parents' rights. Homeschoolers Dirk and Petra Wunderlich lost custody of their four children in a police raid last year. It didn't matter to authorities that the Wunderlichs have created an idyllic setting for their children to learn in, or that the Wunderlich kids are obviously educated, happy, and well-adjusted. German police came to their door in 2013 and threatened to knock it down, then took their children for 3 weeks, only returning them after a court hearing that brought international protest, and under the condition that the Wunderlich children would have to go to public school. The state kept custody so that if the family tried to flee Germany, they would be hunted down like kidnappers. Dirk was defiant.
You have no right to do this, what you do. And don't you think what you are doing? You snatch my children, bring them in foster home, and that is good for welfare? You destroy a family and say that is good for the welfare of the children.
The Wunderlich children describe German public school as a waste of time, with a classroom environment that was out of control.
When there are so many children and they are talking about all kinds of things, it's really loud.
In homeschooling, I felt like we were able to learn a lot more in shorter time. In school, they always make it so long and still you learn less than in homeschool.
They don't learn anything. They get a brainwashing about reality, and also they learn bad behavior.
After a court appeal this year, Dirk and Petra regained custody of their children. They've decided to homeschool them again and face criminal charges.
Well, there's no question that the family are going to be prosecuted criminally for homeschooling.
If they wanted, the Wunderlichs could flee Germany, but they've decided to stay and fight Germany's homeschooling law.
I know that this way I'm going, that is the way of God we have to go, and for this there is nothing to regret or anything.
But the Wunderlichs could lose custody of their children again. Dale Hurd, CBN News in Hessen, Germany.